video, I'm just going to just give a quick overall summary, you know, on the information you're going to need to know as an expert in Yu-Gi-Oh. Well, there's not really much I have to say. If you've been playing Yu-Gi-Oh for this length of time and you've seen, you know, like my last series of videos, you're pretty clued up on what, you know, you need to know in playing Yu-Gi-Oh. Now, one thing that you're going to master, especially if you're going to have a sense for, is the flow of advantage, as I like to call it. When the flow of advantage is in your favor or is in your opponent's favor, then majority of the time, 90% of the time, I would say, you know, the game, you know, is in your favor. If you have the flow of advantage, now what is the flow of advantage? The flow of advantage in Yu-Gi-Oh is when you have added 10 plus cards from your deck to your hand, or have had effects that have allowed you to draw, you know, 10 plus cards from your deck to hand. Whenever you've added cards and it hits a double-digit number in Yu-Gi-Oh, then 90% of the time you have won that duel, especially if you are a competent Yu-Gi-Oh player. You know, very few instances, you know, there are very few instances that, you know, if you've drawn 10 plus cards or added 10 plus cards from your deck to your hand, you know, that you're not going to win that duel, unless you are really not competent in dueling, or you just don't know about Yu-Gi-Oh at all. You know, it's very, extremely rare in the rare instances that, you know, someone, you know, you will lose if you are involving that tactic, if you are fortunate enough to have done added 10 cards or 10 cards. But you, as the opposing player, if you're facing this thing, more often than likely you lose. Now, there is a sort of a balance, is that, you know, there's sort of a breaking point, and the breaking point, I would say, is that if you as a player have added or drawn, let's say around 4 cards, you know. So if you, let's say for example, I have an effect that allows me to draw 4 cards. Still within reason, you know, my opponent has a chance to, you know, win the duel. If they haven't already stopped me drawing with a hand trap or any kind of effect. However, the moment I pass the threshold of 4 and going to 6, then we're starting to get to the flow of advantage, as I like to say, kicks in now. Especially if you're a competent deck builder, when you build your deck, you need to be competent and you have a high level of knowledge when it comes to you. Then the flow of advantage will definitely support you, and you're more often than likely going to win that duel. There's no reason why you should. There really is no reason why you should. Especially with archetype decks, usually archetype decks that Konami releases on a, you know, regular basis, sometimes in sets or booster sets, or even like your low ranking sets. Most of the time, if the deck has added 10 plus cards, by that point you've already achieved your win condition, you know, your ultimate board is already set up. It usually takes, you know, adding 4 to 5 cards, 5 being the midpoint as to where things get a little bit dicey for your opponent. For you as a player, that is the place you want to be, but, you know, as your opponent, you know, that is not the place they want to be, especially if your opponent has added, has added 10 plus cards, or has drawn 10 plus cards. Now, there are some instances where, you know, you can, you know, as the opposing player, come out of this. You know, but it's very, is it rare? No, it isn't rare. Sometimes you as a player, you know, who's added 10 plus cards or has drawn 10 plus cards, makes a mistake. Sometimes maybe you forget, a card effect because you've been doing so many things. You know, you bombard yourself with so much info that you actually forget, you know, your board or the state of your field. Like, I can give you an example. Let's say, like, you know, you play a deck like Altergeist. You know, you have a trap negate on the board, you have a spell negate on the board, you have a spell negate, trap negate, and monster negate. You know, and you have the ability, and then you get a card that allows you to draw 2 cards, and you draw another 2, you draw another 4, you then draw 3, you then draw 4, you then add a card from your deck to your hand, you add a card from the vanity top of the hand, all of a sudden, remember so many things that sometimes it's very easy as a player to forget your current state of the board. Sometimes you may not need to add, you know, cards for the sake of adding cards. That tends to happen a lot, especially when you have a deck that adds a lot of cards. Sometimes, you know, you definitely find players who enter that conundrum of just adding cards for the sake of adding cards, or just drawing for the sake of drawing. I mean, you know, it happens to me as well, you know, when you get a combo-centric deck, it's just like, woohoo, yeah! And you just go, mother hell, let's go, combo! But, you know, after a while, like, you know, the high goes down, and you actually realize, no, I kind of screwed up here. I kind of did a whoopsie. So maybe I shouldn't have gone all crazy and actually used my brains and maybe played it a bit safe. Yeah. This is what we tend to call overextending, where you just like add cards or draw cards for the sake of adding or drawing them without any purpose or strategy or thought. You just do stuff just because you can. This is what is known as overextending, as I just said before. And it happens all the time. So remember, so usually in those instances, your opponent can win, even if, you know, you as a player added 10 plus cards or, you know, drawn 10 plus cards. Overextending is a thing in Yu-Gi-Oh! And it does happen on a regular basis. So this is what makes Yu-Gi-Oh! Really nice, really fun. So you can't really determine, you know, who would win, you know, a game of Yu-Gi-Oh! You can go to overextending, you can go to, you know, you as a player, you know, forgetting your own effect. It can go to all myriads of things, you know. That's the beauty and the spice of Yu-Gi-Oh! As I like to say. So, you know, as an expert, you know, all I can say, you know, as Yu-Gi-Oh! You've been playing for this long now, you're pretty much knowledgeable, you know, Yu-Gi-Oh! Just remember the flow of advantage. The flow of advantage, you know, as I was saying before, it comes down to adding and drawing. If you generally, if you have added 10 plus cards or have drawn 10 plus cards and nothing happens, at this point your opponent doesn't counter these cards, you are playing to the best of your abilities, you know, you don't forget anything, you don't overextend, then 90% of the time you as a player who has, you know, done this on the board and has basically brought about this game state, that game is yours. You have won that game. You know, nothing is going to change that fact. But if, you know, if you fall in trap, you were extending, if you've forgotten some effects, you know, if life hits you, you know, in the game and, you know, some things are forgotten, you know, you will lose. Now, as you play the game, what you want to do is you want to, you know, bluff your opponent, obviously. You want to induce, you know, your opponent making mistakes. You want to act bluff. You want to make, like, you know, you have a hand trap, maybe sometimes you don't have a hand trap. You want to set some traps or set some cells of traps, you know, on the board, which are dangerous but possibly could be harmless. And this is all about you as a player. This is where the mind games come in. And this is where you can be smart and employ your tactics in order for you to win the duel. So, yeah, so remember, it's very important to understand the flow of advantage, as I like to call it. The flow of advantage is basically, you know, the proposition of adding cards and drawing cards. I usually say double digit is usually not a good sign, and, you know, the duel really is not going in your favor. If you've managed to let your opponent draw or add 10 plus cards, and they know the game to a relatively high level, then that duel is lost. If they've added 4 cards, you do have a chance of drawing 4 cards. There is a chance, depending on the state of your hand, the board, the field. But again, you know, it's not really good. You know, the odds in your favor are not really good. If you have built counter strategies to counter your opponent in such instances, then you do have a chance. Usually the four drawing rule or adding of cards, you know, 4 is sort of the best number, I would say. You know, when you have a chance as a player, you know, as the opposing player, you know, to counter your opponent. It's when we start hitting 5 cards, where you've drawn 5 cards, or where you've, when you've drawn 5 cards or added 5 cards, that's when we start to see the slope of, you know, going to lose. because that really is not a good sign. If your opponent has added five cards from the deck to the hand, or drawn the amount of five cards from the deck to the hand, then that is not really a good sign for you as the opposing player. This is not good at all. You need to do something to repair this game shape, because if this continues on to the next turn and the next turn after that, then with the rule as I said before, full of advantage, you will automatically lose, because the opponent will just be getting so much advantage in terms of drawing and adding that you will not have a chance to outplay them, because they'll always have a solution for anything you come up with. So it's very important, as an opposing player, if you're facing such sort of crises, to build your deck as well to combat the flow of advantage that your opponent will bring upon you. It's really important to consider that. And with that being said, I would just like to say you are one step closer to becoming a Yu-Gi-Oh! Master. My faith is in